good morning. Welcome to all. Today I will tell you about the urinary system. Okay, that means how the kidney will work. It is also called the renal system. Before starting the topic, we must understand why we are going to discuss about this topic. What will be the objective of the urinary system? What will be the learning outcome of this topic? After reading these topics, what will be able to learn? Okay, so these are the topics aspects. The objective of this topic is like the you are able to define the organization and function of the urinary system. So you will be also able to define the effect of the hormones that is acting on this renal system, like the ADH, that will be called the antidiuretic hormone. It's vasopressin. You should be able to list the receptors and hormone involved in the urinary system. You should able to understand how the electrolyte will be balanced, how the nephron will function. So these all things will be able to discuss here. You can understand the hormonal and regulation of the urinary system. You can explain that. You can describe the structure and function, that means anatomy and physiology of the kidney, nephron, and indicate how the renal physiology will work. So these are the things. You can also explain that the transmission that is involved in the urination. Now let's start about the urinary system. So first we talk about the urology. You know, urology is a branch of medicine that deals with the urinary system. So it is not obviously it's different things, because logy means a study and uro means you're talking about the urinary system. So those branch who can learn, who can study about the urinary system. So urology is a branch of medicines that deals with the urinary system. So there are the three functions of the urinary system. If you're saying, we will let us see the function of the later slides. Okay, but here we will just brief about the top categories of the function of urinary system. So first it will regulate. Regulate means it can be regulate different things, like the volume, composition, pH. So these all things can be regulated. So these are the first function. Second function will be excrete, because we know the kidney is well known for as an excretory organ. So yes, second function will be excrete. And the third function, it will be also regulate the blood pressure, RBC production, synthesis of calcitriol, and perform the gluconeogenesis. So these all will be categories of the functions. Now the basic gross anatomy. Gross anatomy, that means those anatomy, those structure of the kidney that you can see by without the adding the magnification, without the help of microscope. जो किडनी के वो स्ट्रक्चर हैं जिनको बिना किसी हेल्प के, बिना किसी माइक्रोस्कोप के आप क्या कर सकते हैं, देख सकते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी नो वी हैव टू किडनीज, हमें पता है कि हमारे पास कितनी किडनियां हैं, दो किडनियां हैं. वी कैन सी इट, यू कैन सी अबाउट द किडनी, बट यू कैन नॉट सी द इनसाइड द सेल्स ऑफ द किडनी लाइक नेफ्रॉन. सो दैट इज द माइक्रोस्कोपिक स्ट्रक्चर. Inside the nephron, there is several different structure you cannot see by the naked eye. These are the microscopic. But gross anatomy, you can just see that there are two kidney, two ureter is there, one urinary bladder and one urethra is there. So you can see is this image. This is the gross anatomy. Now come to the kidney focus. Kidney is the paired. We know these are the paired. We have two kidneys, so it's paired, and these are the radish in color, bean-shaped organs, and located just above the waist, between the peritoneum and posterior wall of the abdomen. So, is in kidney? क्या बात कर रहे हैं? We are talking about the location of kidney. We are talking about the shape of the kidney. We are talking about the color of the kidney. तो kidney किस color की है? Reddish color की है. Shape क्या है? Bean-shaped है. लोकेशन क्या है? रेट्रोपेरिटोनियल, अबव द वेस्ट एंड बिटवीन द पेरिटोनियम एंड द पोस्टीरियर वॉल ऑफ द एब्डोमेन. एब्डोमेन के पोस्टीरियर वॉल के पोस्टीरियर है, बिकॉज देयर पोजीशन इज पोस्टीरियर टू द पेरिटोनियम ऑफ द एब्डोमिनल कैविटी. दीज आर सेड टू बी रेट्रोपेरिटोनियल. रेट्रो मींस बिहाइंड, पेरिटोनियल मींस पेरिटोनियम ऑफ एब्डोमेन. So the kidney are, you can also explain the kidney are located between the level of the thoracic and third lumbar vertebra. So last thoracic T12 se leke L3 tak. So you can explain, you can be tell about the kidney in a different way. Like yes, kidney is a reddish in color, lean except retroperitoneal. Just behind the, between the peritoneum and the superior posterior wall of the abdomen. So it is a retroperitoneum, behind the peritoneum. And according to the vertebra, you can also tell the location of the kidney. Like it will be located between the last thoracic, that means T12. So leke kahan tak? L3 tak, third lumbar vertebrae tak. And these are the location, position, where the kidney are partially protected by the 11th and 12th pair of the ribs. Sirf itna hi nahi hai. Kidney partially protected bhi hai. Kisse? 12th aur 11th jo pair ki ribs hai. Jisko hum floating ribs kehte hai. These two ribs are partially protected the kidney. Now there is one another amazing fact that the right kidney is slightly lower than the left. Jo right kidney hai, वो थोड़ी नीचे होती है किसके कंपैरिजन में, लेफ्ट किडनी के कंपैरिजन में. क्यों? बिकॉज राइट किडनी के जो ऊपर के जो पोजीशंस है, जो स्पेस है, दैट विल बी ऑक्युपाइड बाय द लीवर. सो लीवर ऑक्युपाइज द कंसीडरेबल स्पेस ऑन द राइट साइड सुपीरियर टू द किडनी. सो दैट इज द रीजन राइट किडनी इज स्लाइटली लोअर एज कंपेयर टू द लेफ्ट. आई होप यू गॉट द पॉइंट्स. वी इन द फर्स्ट इन दिस स्लाइड वी डिस्कस अबाउट द किडनी शेप्स, size and color and location. Like kidney is reddish in color, bean in shape, retroperitoneal organ. Also you can say located between the last thoracic to the third lumbar, partially protected by the 11th and 12th pair of the ribs. And right kidney is slightly lower as compared to left because that place is, that space is occupied by the liver. Now you can see these are the image of the kidney. You can see the right kidney is slightly lower as compared to the left one. Now talking about the external anatomy of the kidney. We already see external anatomy, that means where it located, T12 to L3. Now that's the important points, internal anatomy of the kidney. The microscopic structure of the kidney. So kidney can be categorized into the three parts: renal cortex, renal medulla, and renal pelvis. So the most outer parts have cortex, then middle part medulla, and the lower part is pelvis. Renal medulla is again divided into three parts: that medulla having the renal pyramids, renal papillae, and renal columns. So usme renal pyramids honge, रीनल पैपिलाई होंगे और रीनल कॉलम्स होंगे. और जो पेल्विस बचा, रीनल पेल्विस, इट विल बी टू पार्ट्स, मेजर कैलिसेस एंड माइनर कैलिसेस. यू कैन सी इन द इमेजेस द मोस्ट अबव सुपर पार्ट इज द रीनल कॉर्टेक्स. नाउ इन द स्ट्रक्चर यू कैन सी द एरिया इज मेंशन इन द रीनल कॉर्टेक्स. बिलो देम देयर इज अ पिरामिड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर दैट इज कॉल्ड द रीनल मेडुला. दिस मेडुला इज हैविंग द थ्री स्ट्रक्चर, पायरामिड्स होंगे, पैपिलाई होंगे और इसमें कॉलम्स होंगे. ओके, पैपिला ऑफ द पायरामिड्स, यू कैन सी द नैरो एंड ऑफ द मेडुला. ये जो पायरामिड्स बने हुए, जो पायरामिड्स स्ट्रक्चर्स हैं, इस पायरामिड्स के दो, एक बेस है, ब्रॉड बेस है जो कॉर्टेक्स की तरफ है, दूसरा लोअर एंड्स है, नैरो एंड्स है. तो नैरो एंड्स है, दैट विल बी कॉल्ड द रीनल पैपिलाई. And the hole will be, is, you can see the pyramid shape, that will be called the renal pyramids. And the narrow end is called the renal papillae. And the space between the these two, that will be the renal columns. You can see there is a major calyces. Renal pelvis is there. The third one, renal pelvis. Renal pelvis, which have the major calyces and minor calyces. You can see the renal pyramids in the renal medulla. A renal column is there between the medulla. So these are the structure. Now, the internal anatomy of this kidney is talking about the three basic structure: cortex, medulla, and pelvis. Cortex होंगे, renal medulla होंगे, renal pelvis होंगे. Renal medulla के तीन parts को divide किया गया है: renal papillae, renal pyramid, renal papillae and renal column. The renal pelvis will be in two parts: major calyces and minor calyces. Now, a frontal section through the kidney reveal the two distinct regions. जो frontal section है kidney का, it will show the two distinct regions: a superficial light red area that will be called the renal cortex. जो सबसे superficial, जो सबसे ऊपर की जो right light red area है, जिसको renal cortex बोलते हैं. और जो deep side है, darker है, reddish है, brown है. Darker red is brown color. Inner region is called the renal medulla. So जो most superficial layer है, जो light red color में है, वो cortex हो गया. उसके अंदर जो brown red is brown, या you can say the darker red is brown color में है, वो renal medulla हो गया, जो inner portion है. And this renal medulla will consist of the several cone shaped structure, जिसको बोलते हैं renal pyramids. And the base of each pyramid face the renal cortex, and its apex, जो उसका narrow end है, that will be called the renal papilla. That will points toward the renal hilum. The renal cortex is the smooth textured area extending from the renal capsule to the base of the renal pyramids and into the space between them. It is divided into an outer cortical zone and inner juxtamedullary zone. So the portion of the renal cortex and that extend between the renal pyramids are called the renal column. So those portion of the renal cortex that extended between the renal pyramids. कॉर्टेक्स का वही हिस्सा जो रीनल पायरामिड्स के बीच में एक्सटेंड है, दैट विल बी कॉल्ड द रीनल कॉलम्स. एंड अ लोब कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ रीनल पायरामिड, इट्स ओवरलाइंग एरिया ऑफ रीनल कॉर्टेक्स एंड वन हाफ ऑफ ईच एडजेसेंट रीनल कॉलम. नाउ यू कैन सी दिस स्ट्रक्चर वेरी क्लियरली मेंशन. द मोस्ट आउटर लेयर इज कॉल्ड द रीनल कॉर्टेक्स, एंड बिलो द रीनल कॉर्टेक्स यू कैन सी द रीनल मेडुला इज देयर. So this pyramid structure is called the renal medulla. This renal pyramids hai. Pyramids ke baad jo uska base structure hai, that will be called the papillae. So yes, that is the renal papillae. And between them, between the two pyramid structure, that portion is called the renal column, the extended part of the cortex. Renal sinus is there, you can see. And the renal capsules you can see. And the lowest part is the renal lobe. Opposite side you can see there is a nephron. The path of urine drainage, like the collecting duct is there. Then it will, from the collecting duct, it will be goes into the papillary duct in the renal pyramid. It will goes into the papillary duct in the renal pyramids. Jo renal pyramids ka structure hai. जिसमें रीनल पैपिलाइज हैं, रीनल कॉलम्स हैं, एंड यू कैन सी देयर रीनल पैपिलाइज देयर. सो फ्रॉम द कलेक्टिंग डक्ट इट विल बी गोज इनटू द पैपिलरी डक्ट इन द रीनल पिरामिड. फ्रॉम देयर इट विल बी गोज इनटू द थर्ड पार्ट, माइनर कैलसेस. जो रीनल पेल्विस है, जो रीनल पेल्विस के दो पार्ट्स बसते हैं, माइनर कैलसेस एंड मेजर कैलसेस. सो इट विल गोज इनटू द माइनर कैलसेस. From minor it will goes into the major, from major it will goes into the renal pelvis. पहले minors में, minor से major में जाएंगे, सबके minor minor छोटे छोटे calyxes होंगे, फिर ये छोटे छोटे calyxes मिलके कुछ बड़े calyxes मिलेंगे, दो तीन बड़े calyxes होंगे major calyxes, फिर ये major calyxes में से renal pelvis में, and then from renal pelvis it will goes into the ureter, और ureter से urinary bladder में, and then it will be out. So together, the renal cortex and the renal pyramids are of the renal medulla constitute the parenchyma of the kidney. So the renal cortex and renal pyramids, it constitute the parenchyma, the functional portion of the kidney, jisko functional portions bolte hain. Within the parenchyma are the functional unit of the kidney. That will be the nephron, a million microscopic structures. Millions में होंगे, लाखों में पाए जाएंगे, और किसमें होंगे? Parenchyma में. Parenchyma क्या है? जो cortex और pyramids है. इनको दोनों को साथ मिला के बोलते हैं पेरेन्काइमा। सो यस विद इन द पेरेन्काइमा इज अ नेफ्रॉन विल बी प्रेजेंट एंड नेफ्रॉन इज अ फंक्शनल यूनिट ऑफ द किडनी। नाउ यूरिन फॉर्म बाय द नेफ्रॉन ड्रेन्स इनटू द लार्ज कैपिलरी डक्ट्स व्हिच एक्सटेंड्स थ्रू द रीनल पैपिलाई। Now, urine formed by the nephron that will drain into the large papillary duct which extend through the renal papillae of the pyramids. The papillary ducts drain into the cup-like structure called the minor and major calyces, each kidney having 8 to 18 minor calyces, 2 or 3 major calyces. A minor calyces receive the urine from the papillary ducts and one renal papillary and deliver to the major calyces, as I told you earlier. How the urine will be drained? हमने सब पहले बताया था कि यूरिन कैसे फ्लो कर रही है। The previous structure, if you remember, that means it will drain into the papillary duct. From papillary duct, it will be goes into the minor calyces. From minor calyces is cup-like structure. Then it will go into the major calyces. And each kidney having 8 to 18 minor calyces. और हर किडनी में लगभग 8 से 18 minor calyces होते हैं जो 2 से 3 major calyces से मिलते हैं. So minor calyces receive the urine from the papillary duct. जो minor calyces होते हैं वो urine receive कर रहे हैं किससे? Papillary duct से, of the renal papilla, and deliver it to the major calyces. And from the major calyces, urine will drain into the renal pelvis area, the large cavities hai, and then it will be out the ureter and bladder and then it will goes out. Another thing that we have to understand, how the blood supply of the kidney, kidney mein blood ki supply kaise hoti hai? That is another important point. How it will be supplied? Blood ki supply kidney mein kaise ho rahi hai? You will see there is two types of the blood vessel, the renal artery and renal vein. Okay, one will be renal artery and renal vein. Now this renal artery will go inside the kidney that will carry the oxygenated bloods from the heart. So sabse pehle aorta se blood nikla, heart ke aorta se blood niklega. From aorta, blood will go into the renal artery. Ab renal artery se blood kahan jayega? It will go to the segmental artery, because one renal artery goes inside into the kidney and it will divide it, segmented into the branch. So that is called the segmental artery. Segmental artery mein jayenge. Segmental artery se ye interlobar artery mein jayenge. Okay, after segmental artery, this artery will be goes and divided into the interlobar artery. फिर interlobar artery से ये जाएंगे arcuate artery में. Arcuate artery that is surrounded the medulla and also in the cortex. So from aorta blood goes into the renal artery. From renal artery it will go segmental, segmental to the interlobar artery, interlobar artery to arcuate artery. From arcuate artery it will goes to the cortical radiate artery. अब कहाँ जाएगा? Cortical radiate artery में, जो cortex में फैले हुए होते हैं. And we know the nephron main structure, glomerulus, or you can say the renal corpuscles will present in the cortex. So from this cortical radiate artery, blood will goes into the afferent arterioles, और afferent arterioles से glomerulus में जाएगा, glomerulus से फिर efferent से निकलेगा. और efferent से जब ये निकलेगा, from efferent से, then it will be also goes into the peritubular capillaries and vasa recta. Because these are going to circulate and surrounded the renal tubules. So these are the peritubular capillaries. And from peritubular capillaries, it will goes into the cortical radiate vein. From cortical radiate vein, it will go arcuate radiate vein. From arcuate, it will go the interlobar vein. Interlobar vein say renal vein. Renal vein say fir inferior vena cava. Fir inferior vena cava. So it will goes into the heart. From heart it will be goes again into the pumped to the lungs. Lungs se purify karke wapas heart mein aayenge, and then it will be pulled again into the aorta. So these are the circulation it will be start. Now you will see in the kidney where these artery are placed. You can see the most top is the cortical radiate vein. Similarly, you can see below cortical radiate artery. So those thing that is circulated in this area, then arcuate vein, arcuate artery is there, then interlobar vein and interlobar artery is there, then segmental artery is there. Now come to the below part, and you will see there regional pelvis, ureter, adrenal cortex. So these are the blood supply. So सबसे पहले blood heart से निकलेगा. Heart से निकलने के बाद it will pump into the aorta. Aorta से it will pass to the renal artery. Renal artery से segmental artery. Segmental artery से interlobar artery. Interlobar artery से arcuate artery. Arcuate artery से cortical radiate artery. And then it will pass into the nephron. Filter is there. Afferent. Then release from the efferent. And from the efferent से निकलते वक्त it will pass into the peritubular capillaries. And then it will be goes into the cortical radiate vein. Just artery को vein में convert करना है. So it will cortical radiate vein, then arcuate vein, interlobar vein, and renal vein and inferior vein आके बाद then it will goes into the heart. And from the heart it will goes into the right atrium of the heart because inferior vein आके बाद will carry the blood to the right side. So from the right atrium it will goes into the right ventricle, then it will be pumped through the pulmonary artery into the lungs. Where it will be oxidized when the oxygen will be replaced with the carbon dioxide present in the blood, and this blood is then transported to the left side of the heart, that will be the left auricles through the pulmonary vein. Then it will be goes into the left ventricle. From left ventricle it will pumped into the aorta, and it will goes into the systemic artery and comes in the renal artery again. So these are the blood supply that will be circulate through the whole process. Now what is the function of the kidney? How kidney perform the different function? So first function that means the kidney can regulate the blood ionic composition. Now we know there is a different ions is there, like the sodium, potassium, calcium, chloride, phosphate. So these ions, kidney will help to regulate the level of these ions inside the blood. Kidney will also help to regulate the blood pH because kidney excrete a variable amount of hydrogen ions into the urine and conserve the bicarbonate. So it will really excrete the hydrogen ions and conserve the bicarbonate ion, and bicarbonate ion is act as a important buffer. So yes, in the blood it will regulate the blood pH. Another is the regulation of blood volume. By excreting and conserving the water, kidney can regulate the volume of the fluid. Yeah, you can say the volume of the blood. The kidney adjusts the blood volume by conserving or eliminating the water in the urine. An increase in the blood volume, increase in the blood pressure, and a decrease in the blood volume, decrease the blood pressure. So yes, another function is the kidney can be used in the regulation of blood pressure. So kidney also have to regulate the blood pressure by secreting the enzyme renin. Okay, so which activate the renin angiotensin aldosterone pathway and increase the renin, cause an increase in the blood pressure. We know by increasing the renin, this will convert the angiotensinogen that is released from the liver into the angiotensin first, and from angiotensin first it will convert into angiotensin second, and angiotensin second is a potent vasoconstrictor which will causes the increase in the BP. It will also angiotensin second convert into angiotensin third will causes the aldosterone secretion that causes the sodium and water retention, so blood volume will be increased. So yes, this will also help to regulate the blood pressure. Another function of the kidney is to maintenance of blood osmolarity. So by separating, regulating the loss of water and loss of solute in the urine, kidney maintain a relative constant blood osmolarity close to 300 milliosmoles per liter. Now we know through the kidney different things can be excreted, different ions can be excreted, but the loss of water and loss of solute in the urine, so it is not possible. So by separately regulating the loss of water, how much amount water we can excrete, how much amount of the solutes we can excrete, so kidney will control with these things and it will maintain the blood osmolarity. Production of hormone. The kidney produce two hormones, calcitriol and erythropoietins. So do tarah ke hormones kidney excrete kar sakti hai. Now by the calcitriol, that is the active form of vitamin D, that will help the regulate regulate the calcium homeostasis and erythropoietin that will stimulate the production of RBC. Blood glucose can be also maintained by the kidney. Like the liver, kidney can use the amino acid glutamine in gluconeogenesis, the synthesis of new glucose molecules. They can then release the glucose into the blood and help to maintain a normal blood glucose level. As same we have seen in the liver, where the liver will use the glycogen and convert into the glucose. Okay. Similarly, in kidney, use the amino acid glutamine. Okay, jo glutamines hote hain, jo amino acids hote hain, glutamine in gluconeogenesis process. And through the gluconeogenesis process, it will produce, it will synthesize the new molecules of the glucose. And when the time will come, they can release these glucose into the blood and maintain the blood glucose level. So yes, kidney can also regulate the blood glucose level. Another function of the kidney is to excrete off the waste and foreign substance. Now, how kidney can excrete of the waste and foreign substance? We can understand that these points. By forming urine, we know kidney can, that is the most special function, most prominent and most known function of the kidney, that is the urine excretion. So by forming urine, the kidney help excrete the waste. Whatever the waste material present inside the body, that can be excreted through the kidney. Now, substance that have no useful function in the body, some waste excreted in urine result from metabolic reaction in the body. So we know in our body there is a metabolic reactions will be going on. Should due to that reaction, if there is any side product or any those products will be formed that is not useful for the body, there is no importance for the body, there is not required in the body, then what will happen? The body will be release it, and that is the only possible through the these urine excretion. So yes, body will regulate these foreign substances, and waste material can be removed from the body, like ammonia, urea, from the deamination of the amino acid, bilirubin from the catabolism of hemoglobin, creatinine for the breakdown of creatinine phosphate. Like when we learn in the RBC, jab RBC ka breakdown hota hai, jab hemoglobin ka breakdown hota hai, tootta hai, to bilirubin nikalta hai, aur that will be excreted from the kidney. Similarly, जब अमीनो एसिड्स के डीएमिनेशन होंगे, अमीनो ग्रुप रिमूव होगा, तो अमोनिया यूरिया विल बी एक्सक्रीटेड. सो लाइक दीज आर द थिंग्स. एंड यूरिक एसिड फ्रॉम द कैटाबोलिज्म ऑफ द न्यूक्लिक एसिड्स. सो अदर वेस्ट एक्सक्रीटेड इन द यूरिन आर फॉरेन सब्सटेंसेस फ्रॉम द डाइट सच एज द ड्रग्स एंड एनवायरमेंटल टॉक्सिंस. नाउ इफ यू लुक लाइक एट द नेफ्रॉन एनाटॉमी, then you can understand nephron having the two parts. One is the glomerulus and Bowman capsules. Then renal tubules will be there. So all the nephron will be categorized into the two parts. One is the renal corpuscles. Second is the renal tubules. Renal corpuscles wo parts hote hain jisme glomerulus aur Bowman capsule hote hain. Otherwise all things are the renal tubules jisme PCT, proximal convoluted tubule, loop of Henle and distal convoluted tubule or DCT. So there are the two types of the nephron, that is the cortical nephron and juxtamedullary nephron will be here. Now see, nephron are the functional unit of the kidney. Nephron kya hai? Nephronic functional unit hai kidney ka, humne pehle discuss kiya tha. Each nephron consists of two parts, aur har nephron mein do parts hote hain, renal corpuscles and renal tubules. Renal corpuscles where the blood plasma is filtered and tubules where the filtered fluid is passed. So two component of the renal corpuscles are the glomerulus, that is the capillary like structures, capillary network, and the glomerular Bowman's capsule. Combinedly they are called the renal corpuscles. So nephron mein jo structure hai, glomerulus hai jo capillaries ka network hai, aur dusra jo glomerular hai jo Bowman's capsule hai, U-shaped structures hai jo. These are combinedly called the renal corpuscles. A double walled epithelial cup Bowman's capsule that surrounds the glomerular capillaries. Blood plasma is filtered in the glomerular capsule and then filtered fluid passes into the renal tubules, which has three main junctions. So when the blood plasma is filtered into the glomerular capsule, as you can say, the renal capsules, in the renal corpuscles, then this filtered fluid passes into the renal tubules. That means it will be goes into the PCT, loop of Henle, and DCT. In the order that fluid passes through them, the renal tubule consists of these three parts. Now, why it is called, we know, renal tubules are having the PCT, loop of Henle, and DCT. Proximal convoluted tubule, proximal, that is the nearer side. Okay, so those part of the tubule that is attached to the glomerular capsule are the proximal parts. And distal will denote that is away, further away from the glomerulus. So that is called the proximal, that is called the distal. And convoluted means the highly coiled or tightly coiled rather than a straight. You can see the structure of the nephron, it is a coiled structure. So that is called the convoluted convolution. And the corpuscles are both convoluted tubules lies within the renal cortex. The loop of Henle extend into the renal medulla, makes a hairpin turn and then return to the renal cortex. Now the distal convoluted tubules of the several nephron empty in a single collecting duct. The distal convoluted tubules of several nephron empty into the single collecting duct. And these collecting duct that unit and convert into the several hundred large papillary duct, then drain into the minor calyces or the major calyces or fibro excreted will be out. Now you can see the structure here. You can see the structure of the nephron who have, which has the U-like structure, renal corpuscles having a red artery showing, that is the glomerulus, that will be capillaries, blood capillaries, and Bowman's capsule, collectively called the renal corpuscles. Kidney, we will also see it, very lots of the things, because in kidney, in the nephron, because as I told you, nephron is completely divided into two parts, renal corpuscles and renal tubules. Renal corpuscles will contains the glomerulus and the Bowman's capsule. Glomerulus and Bowman's capsule combinedly called the renal corpuscles. Glomerulus, jo blood capillaries hai, wo glomerulus kehlati hai. Or jo U-shaped structures hai, double epithelial layers ki, that will be called the Bowman capsule, okay, or glomerular capsule. Sorry. So in this case, then these are gonadal. Then the renal corpuscles are connected with the renal tubules, and these renal tubules having the three structure PCT, proximal convoluted tubules. So those convolution tubules, you can see the coil tubules, that is called the convoluted tubules. Proximal, that means near the glomerulus, so it is called the PCT. And DCT is away from the glomerulus, so it is called the distal convoluted tubule. And the remaining center portion is called the loop of Henle. You can see the nephron and PCT are present in the cortex area of the cortex of the kidney. Now kidney having the three structure, no? Cortex, medulla, and pelvis. You can see there is a small line, the cortex is mentioned here. So the loop of Henle is present into the renal medulla. Otherwise, renal corpuscles and the PCT are present in the cortex, then it will goes into the medulla and making again a U-tube structure, a pin-like folds, and going again into the cortex. So yes, again the DCT is going into the cortex, distal convoluted tubule. So these are the parts of the nephron and they are going to filter. So when the blood will come from the afferent artery to the this glomerular capillaries, then the blood plasma is filtered through the glomerulus, okay, through the Bowman's capsule, and then filtered, the filtrate is going into the renal tubules, and then it will goes into collected into the collecting ducts. From collecting duct, it will goes into the papillary. From papillary, it will goes into the minor calyces. From minor, it will goes into the major calyces. From major, then it will be goes into the renal pelvis, then ureter, and then the excreted will be out. So these are the things about the nephron. Now here are some questions, like what is the name for the entry point to the kidney for nerves? What is the name for the entry point to the kidney for nerves, blood vessels, ureter, and lymphatics? Calyx, hilus, pelvis, pyramid. So yes, it is a hilus. So answer B is correct. Another things we can see here. Where are all the glomeruli of the kidneys located? So you can see there's a different glomeruli of the kidneys located, that is in the medulla, in the columns, in the pyramids, and in the cortex. So you can see here, all the glomeruli of the kidney are located in the cortex area. So here, obviously, that means answer D is correct. What structure does the blood from the afferent arteriole enter? Kis structure mein afferent arteriole enter karta hai? Blood from the afferent arteriole. Afferent arteriole se jo blood aa raha hai, wo kis structure mein enter karta hai? Peritubular capillaries mein, osharectum mein, glomerulus mein, ya Bowman's capsule mein? So we know there is a structure that will be called the glomerulus, and glomerulus is a capillary like structure, and that capillaries like structure is containing the afferent artery which is carrying the blood. So yes, answer C is correct. Another things today we are here, we can see which part of the nephron is impermeable to water. Which part of the nephron is impermeable to water? Proximal conduit tubule, distal conduit tubule, ascending limb of loop of Henle. So yes, C, ascending limb is impermeable to water. So C is correct. Solute move from the blood into the glomerular capillaries into the Bowman's capsule due to which of the following influences? You can see there's a different pressure, like the osmotic pressure differences is there. Diffusion down the concentration gradient is there, by active transport is there, and hydrostatic pressure differences is there. But we're talking about the solute will move from blood in the glomerular capillaries into the Bowman's capsule due to which of the following influences? So osmotic pressure involvement nahi honge, usme diffusions ke nahi honge, active transport ke nahi honge, but hydrostatic pressure involvement will be there. So yes, answer D is correct. Now, which material is secreted into the filtrate in the kidney tubule? So in the renal tubules, which material is secreted? You can see water is there, urea is there, sodium is there, albumin is there. So urea will be excreted, say you can say the secreted into the kidney tubules. Another questions we have, which of the following happens as we descend the deeper into the kidney medulla? Which of the following happens as we descend the deeper? So concentration of the interstitial fluid does not change. Concentration of the interstitial fluid increase. Concentration of filtrate within the tubule increase. Concentration of the interstitial fluid decrease. So yes, concentration of the interstitial fluid increases. Another question we have, which part of the renal tubule is impermeable to water? We know that is the ascending limb of loop of Henle. That is impermeable to water but permeable to solutes. Yes, answer A is correct. In the glomerulus, what is method by which solute are transferred from the blood to the Bowman capsule? Kaun sa method hai? Diffusion, active transport, secretion, filtration. So it's filtration. Answer D is correct. What is the entry point to the kidney for the renal artery, renal vein, lymphatic, and nerve called? Renal hilus is there, where that is the entry point of the kidney. Jahan se renal ki artery, vein, lymphatic, and nerves sab entry marte hain, that will be the renal hilus. So yes, answer B is correct. Now in the today lecture, we talk about the external anatomy of the kidney. Jisme humne gross morphology mein two kidney, two ureter, then bladder and urethra will be there. Similarly, we have seen the internal anatomy of the kidney, जिसमें हमने kidney के color की बात की, जो reddish colors में है, shape bean shapes की, then the location of the kidney, that is the retroperitoneal organs, okay, behind the peritoneum. We also seen the location between the last thoracic to the third lumbar vertebra. We also know that right kidney is slightly lower as compared to left, because liver is occupied in that place. With the internal anatomy, these are with these kidney structure than internal anatomy of the kidney. That means kidney are divided into three structure, three parts: renal cortex, renal medulla, and renal pelvis. Then medulla will be divided again into the renal pyramids, renal papillae, and the renal columns. So, the most superficial layer set, that will be cortex. Then deep down, reddish brown color will be medulla, and that medulla is having a pyramid structure that will be called the renal pyramids, and the pyramid having the broad structure, base structure that will be toward the cortex, and the narrow opposite side is the narrow structure that will be called the renal papillae, and the extended part of the cortex between the pyramids it called the renal columns. And there is a several minor calluses emerges from after the papillae, so the collecting ducts will be powered the collecting fluids into the these minor calluses. From the minor calluses this fluid goes into the major calluses, and from the major calluses it will goes into the renal pelvis, and from renal pelvis it will be released into the ureter. So these all things learned. Then we have seen the nephron, that is a functional unit of the kidney, present in the parenchyma. You can say that is the parts of the cortex and medulla, collectively called the parenchyma. And we have seen the nephron having the two parts, renal corpuscles, renal tubules. Renal corpuscles mein uske glomerulus, jo capillaries, blood capillaries hain, network of capillaries se wo aate hain, and dusre hai Bowman's capsules. And then renal tubule having the PCT, proximal terminal tubules, loop of Henle having the descending loop of Henle and ascending loop of Henle. Then distal tubule, the DCT, distal columnar tubules, and the collecting duct is there. Okay, so these are the parts of the nephron, and nephron will present in the cortex area, and their loop of Henle will go to the medulla. So these are all things we have discussed today, and these are the reference, so you can go through these book, and after that things we will meet again in the next class with some new and fantastic like topics, some interesting topic. Till then, thank you.